In this lecture, we will discuss about analysis of 6 pulse converter without source inductance. There are some assumptions we will consider in this session. These assumptions are like the power source is assumed to be sinusoidal in nature, consisting of EMFs of constant voltage and frequency in series with lossless inductances. Then the direct current is assumed to be constant and ripple free. The SCRs are assumed to have zero forward resistance, and they are assumed to have infinite inverse resistance. The SCRs are fired at equal interval of time. That means after every 60 degree, new SCR is fired. This is circuit diagram of 6 pulse converter. It consists of 6 SCRs, and these SCRs are given names like 1, 3 and 5 and 4, 6, 2. The upper 3 SCRs represents positive group, and 3 SCRs at bottom represents negative group. This bridge is fed from 3 phase AC supply. AC supply consists of 3 phase voltages, namely EA, EB and EC. These are the instantaneous values of phase voltages. LC represents the inductance of the source, or actually it is the inductance of secondary winding of transformer. The current in SCR1 is represented by I1. I3 represents current in SCR3. I5 represents current in SCR5. Similarly, I4, I6 and I2. IA, IB and IC represents instantaneous value of current in phase A, phase B and phase C. ID represents direct current in the load, and this current is assumed to be ripple free because of the smoothing reactor LD on output side. These are line to neutral source voltages, and then we have 3 line to line voltages. These voltages are expressed by using cosine function. The phase voltage or line to neutral voltage EA is represented by the vector here, and it is at an angle 60 degree from reference axis. EA equal to EM cos omega t plus 60 degree. Similarly, EB is having 60 degree phase displacement with respect to EB. So therefore, the expression for EB is EM cos omega t minus 60 degree. Similarly, EC is having 180 degree phase displacement with respect to reference axis, and therefore the equation is EM cos omega t minus 180 degree. The line voltages, for example, EAC is equal to EA minus EC. So EA is here and this is EC. So the vector addition of these two vectors is, say, EAC, that is line voltage. Similarly, other line voltages can be obtained from corresponding phase voltages. For example, EBA is EB minus EA, and ECA is equal to EC minus EB. So by substituting values of EA, EB and EC in these equations, we obtain 3 line to line voltages. Now let's assume that Each SCR in this bridge is introduced at an angle of 60 degree. And let us consider that the alpha is equal to 0 degree. Alpha equal to 0 degree represents the case of three-phase diode rectifier. So the output voltage of this particular bridge is same as the output voltage of three-phase diode rectifier. Now let us try to understand the working of this three-phase 6-pulse converter. Under the assumption that alpha is equal to 60 degree and after every 60 degree new SCR is introduced, it is very easy to understand the working of this particular three-phase 6-pulse converter. Now let's assume that phase voltage, say EB and EC. So at say angle 0 degree, when omega t, this axis is omega t, so when angle omega t is equal to 0 degree, say SCR I3 or T3 is fired. So T3 is here. Now at this instant, phase voltage EB is more positive compared to other phase voltages, say EA and EB, sorry EC. And therefore, this thyristor T3 can be fired because it is positive biased. If the firing pulse is given at alpha equal to 0 degree, then SCR3 will start conducting. Now prior to SCR3, SCR1 was conducting, and SCR1 was introduced at angle say minus 120 degree, and there was SCR6 which was already conducting, because at omega t equal to minus 120 degree, EB was highly negative. So this EB is connected to SCR6. So EB is connected to the cathode of SCR6 or T6. So it was fired prior to this angle and it was conducting. So from minus 20 degree onwards, SCR1 and 6, they were conducting, and at omega t equal to minus 60 degree, SCR2 was introduced, because at omega t equal to minus 60 degree, EC becomes highly negative compared to EB and EA. So EC, which is here, is connected to the cathode of SCR2, and it is also connected to the anode of SCR5 or T5. So when angle omega t equal to minus 60 degree, SCR2 was introduced, so the current from 6 to 2 got transferred, the current from SCR6 got transferred to SCR2 at an angle omega t equal to minus 60 degree. So from this instant onward, SCR1 and 2 were conducting, that is T1 and T2 were conducting, and at an angle 0, say omega t equal to 0, SCR3 was fired because EB is more positive than EA and EC, and therefore since SCR3 was forward biased, it was introduced by giving pulse to its gate terminal. So you can notice that prior to introduction of say SCR3, SCR2 was already carrying current. That means SCR1 was carrying current from say source to load, and SCR2 2 was returning the current back to the source. At this instant, omega t equal to 60 degrees, SCR3 is introduced, and current from SCR1 gets transferred to SCR3 almost instantaneously, because we are assuming that these source inductances have no effect on the output of this 6 pulse converter. So after SCR3 or T3 is introduced at omega t equal to 0 degree, the current from the source to load is taken by SCR3 and it is returned by SCR2. And again at omega t equal to 60 degree, SCR4 is introduced, and so on. Now you can notice that the output voltage is the difference of phase voltages. Say for example, phase voltage EB and phase voltage EC represent line voltage EBC. So during this period, say SCR3 was introduced and SCR2 was already conducting. So from omega t equal to 0 to 60 degree, the voltage across the load was EBC, that is the vector difference of phase voltage EB and EC. And therefore, you can see here that the output voltage VD is represented here as a line voltage. So at any point of time, we observe that only two SCRs are conducting, one SCR from positive group and one SCR from negative group. And therefore, the voltage across the load is always the line voltage, which is shown here. So from this sketch B, we understand that the conduction pattern is, say, 1, 2, 2, 3, then 3, 4, then 4, 5, then 5, 6, then 6, 1, and so on. So the upper part represents current in the wall in positive group, and the lower part represents current in the wall present in the negative group. Now figure C represents the current in phase A. Now phase A is associated with, say, two SCRs, SCR1 and SCR4, or T1 and T4. T1 or SCR1 carries the current towards the load. Therefore, the current in SCR1 or T1 is always a positive current, or it represents the positive cycle, whereas SCR4 or say T4 returns the current to phase A, and therefore the current in SCR4 or T4 is a part of negative cycle of the sinusoidal current represented by, say, IA. Now the current is not sinusoidal because, say for example, during this period, say omega t equal to minus 120 degree to 0, SCR1 is carrying current. So from omega t equal to 0 degree to omega t equal to 60 degree, neither SCR1 nor SCR4 is carrying current. So we notice that the current in SCR1 flows during a period when angle omega t equal to minus 120 degree to when angle omega t equal to 0 degree. So therefore, for a period of 120 degree, there is a current in phase A, which is shown here. Prior to that, the ACRs 3 and 6 were conducting. So neither 3 or 6 is connected to phase A. So current in phase A was 0 until the angle minus 120 degree is reached. And from minus 120 degree to 0 degree, ACR 1 was carrying current. Therefore, this current is shown as a positive half cycle, and this current continue to flow for 120 degree. Now from omega t equal to 0 to say 60 degree, in this period ACR 3 is carrying current, whereas ACR 2 is retaining the current. So in this period, neither ACR 1 nor ACR 4 is conducting, therefore current in phase A becomes 0. So at omega t equal to 60 degree, ACR 4 is introduced and it conducts for again another 120 degree, that is from omega t equal to 60 degree to omega t equal to 180 degree, and therefore the ACR 4 returns the current back to phase A through say ACR 3 as well as ACR 5. So this current is shown here. Again at omega t equal to 180 degree, ACR 6 is introduced. So current now flows from source to load through 5 and 6. So in this particular region, that is omega t equal to 180 degree to omega t equal to 240 degree, neither ACR 1 nor ACR 4 is in the circuit, and therefore the current is again 0 in this particular region. So we understand that the current is not a sinusoidal, but current is a discontinuous. Now this current remains constant during this 120 degree because the smoothing reactor removes all the ripples and the current becomes a constant. So it is not a sinusoidal current, but it is having a shape like a square wave. Now we can see that the voltage which appears across load consists of pulses of 60 degree, and these pulses represents line voltages. So for one cycle of sinusoidal AC supply, we get 6 such pulses on output side, and hence the name is 6 pulse converter. Now if you consider a typical pulse, then area A0 represents the area of pulse EAC, the phase voltages say EA, EB and this is EC. These three phase voltages are displaced by an angle of 120 degree. So the same area can be seen here also. So the average DC voltage or average output voltage can be calculated by integrating this area or by taking the average of this area A0. We notice here this output voltage is equal to integration of area say A0 or integration of area under say arc EAC with respect to theta divided by the base. The base is of 60 degree, that is pi by 3. So this is actually divided by pi by 3, which is actually now 3 by pi. So by substituting the value of EAC, average value of DC voltage, which is equal to 1.65 times EM, or it is written in terms of line voltage, 1.35 times line voltages. So there are two variables involved here, EM represents the maximum value, which is here, and EL represents, say, line voltage or RMS value of line voltage, and EM is the peak value of AC voltage. The DC output VDO is obtained for alpha equal to 0 degree. However, if the alpha is not equal to, say, 0 degree, it is having certain value. That means the firing of ACRs is delayed by, say, alpha degree. In that case, we have to consider a value of alpha here. So the net firing angle would be, say, for example, this is alpha. The net firing angle would be this minus 60 plus alpha, and this 0 will be further advanced by alpha. So it will be 0 plus alpha. So this is 0 plus alpha. So these limits are shown here, alpha minus 60 degree, and this is alpha. And then same line voltage is considered here, and we obtain the output voltage VD is equal to VDO into cos alpha, where VDO is already obtained here, which is 1.65 times the maximum value or 1.35 times line voltage. Now in this particular slide, the same expression is shown, but then the waveforms shown includes angle alpha, and we can notice that earlier alpha was equal to 0, but now it is, say, having some angle of advance alpha. So as the magnitude of alpha increases, we notice that the area of this area below this arc goes on reducing, and that can be shown here by this expression in which there is term cos alpha. So when alpha is equal to 0, the output voltage VD is equal to VDO, that is maximum voltage. However, as alpha increases towards, say, 90 degree, at exactly alpha equal to 90 degree, say, for example, cos 90 becomes equal to 0, and therefore the output voltage becomes 0. Now we will obtain the value of line current by using Fourier analysis. So we will try to obtain the value of, say, line current IA by considering the conduction of different ACRs. You can see here there are three phase voltages, or say line to neutral voltages, namely VA, VB and VC, and these voltages are apart from each other by an angle of 120 degree. By using these phase voltages, say VA, VB and VC, which are actually same as EA, EB and EC as discussed in previous slide, by using these voltages, say VA, VB and VC, we have line voltages, say VAB, VAC, VBC and so on. These line voltages are same as line voltages, say EAB, EAB, or say EBA and so on. Let us consider that a delay angle of alpha is introduced. So say at angle omega t equal to pi by 6 plus alpha, that means at this instant, SCR 1 is introduced. Prior to alpha, this instant, the SCR 5 and 6, they were carrying current, and at this angle of, say, pi by 6 plus alpha, SCR 1 is introduced. So the current gets transferred instantaneously from SCR 5 to 1, and SCR 1 starts conducting, and SCR6 returns the current during this period. And the line voltage which appears across the load is now VAB. At this angle, this particular angle, SCR2 is introduced, and now the current is carried from source to load by means of say 1 and 2. At this angle, 5 pi by 6 plus alpha, SCR3 is introduced. The current gets transferred from 1 to 3. And therefore, the current in SCR1 stops. And from this angle, say this angle is shown here, where we can notice that the voltage VBC appears across the load. That means VB minus VC. So VB is here, which is associated with SCR3. So SCR3 carries current from say phase B to load, and the other SCR is returning the current, and that is SCR2, that is say C, phase C. So phase C is here and SCR2 is returning the current. So this period is shown here, that SCR3 is carrying current towards the load, whereas SCR2 is returning the current. Now in this particular period, neither 1 nor 4, none of the SCR is say conducting, and therefore the current becomes 0, which is shown by this particular line. So this duration is of say 60 degree, during which SCR 2 and 3 are carrying current, and SCR 1 is not conducting, neither SCR 4 is conducting. At this angle, 7 pi by 6 plus alpha, at this instant exactly, where VB is positive and VA is negative, say SCR 4 is introduced here. As soon as SCR 4 is introduced, the current from 2 is transferred to 4. And now SCR 3 and 4 continue to carry the current. And at this particular angle, SCR5 is introduced. So current is now transferred from 3 to 5, and SCR 4 and 5 continue to carry the current until this angle 11 pi by 6 plus alpha is reached. That is this particular angle. So during this 120 degree, the current is returned from the load to the source by SCR4. So this is the one cycle of current. And now let us obtain the fundamental component of this current IA by using Fourier analysis. So the typical angles which we need to consider are, say for positive cycle, pi by 6 plus alpha to 5 pi by 6 plus alpha, and for negative part, 7 pi by 6 plus alpha to 11 pi by 6 plus alpha. Now this particular waveform which we discussed on previous slide can be represented by a Fourier series, which is shown here. That is IA is equal to A0 plus summation of AN cos n omega t plus BN sin n omega t, and summation is from say n equal to 1 to infinity, where A0 represents the average value of input current, and then AN is defined by this expression, and BN which is defined here. So since the waveform of current is symmetrical about say horizontal axis, therefore the magnitude of A0 is always 0. Now AN is written by this expression, that is 1 upon pi 0 to 2 pi IA into cos n omega t d omega t. So the value of IA as we discussed, for a positive part, say is valid from, or it is having a finite value from angle pi by 6 plus alpha to 5 pi by 6 plus alpha, and for negative part, that is minus IL, this is a plus IL instead of IA, we consider it as a IL, or we can consider as a ID also. So for negative part, it is 7 pi by 6 plus alpha to 11 pi by 6 plus alpha. So when this integral is solved, we obtain the value of say an like this. An is having two values for different values of n, and these two values are shown here. Similarly, the definition of bn is 1 upon pi 0 to 2 pi ia sin n omega t d omega t. Again, we have substituted for ia by considering positive part and negative part of the waveform of current. As before, the positive part is valid during this period, that is pi by 6 plus alpha to 5 pi by 6 plus alpha, and negative part is valid during this period, 7 pi by 6 plus alpha to 11 pi by 6 plus alpha. So after solving this integral, we obtain the magnitude or the values of bn, and these, there are two values, and these two values are shown here for different values of n. Now we know that the RMS value of this particular current can be defined as 1 upon root 2 an square plus bn square raised to half. So we have already obtained the value of an and bn. So we obtain this RMS value of nth harmonic current, and for a fundamental value of this RMS value of current, we substitute n is equal to 1, so it becomes IS1, and after solving this we get its value as root 6 by pi IL or ID. This value of say fundamental component is rewritten as I say S1 is equal to, it is root 6 by pi ID, which is same as IL1, say for example. And now let us obtain the relation between power factor of converter and the firing angle alpha. Let us assume that the converter is not having any losses, all the losses are neglected, and therefore we can write that the AC power is equal to DC power. AC power can be written by this expression, 3 times phase voltage into say phase current, because it is a star connected system, phase current and line currents are same. So again, the equation of power, AC power, is 3 times this phase voltage, phase current into cos alpha, that's power factor, is equal to the DC power, which is simply product of VD into ID. Now we have already obtained these relations, that is the fundamental value of RMS current, input current. Now you can notice here the input power uses the fundamental value, because the fundamental value of current is only useful or is responsible to get useful power. Other values are the harmonics, and they are of no use as far as useful power is concerned. So we know that VD is equal to VD0 cos alpha. So it is substituted here, and we have substituted value of say IL1, which is root 6 by pi, and this is substituted here, same expression is rewritten here, this is 3 as it is, which is here, then ELN, that is phase voltage, which is here. And for IL1, we have written root 6 by pi, which is obtained here, and cos phi as it is. And on right hand side, we have VD into ID. So VD is replaced by, say, this particular VD0. VD0 is 3 root 3 by pi into ELN. So it is written here, and ID is as it is, cos alpha is there. So all the common quantities on either side are cancelled, and we obtain this expression. So we can conclude that in the case of 6 pulse converter, the power factor cos phi is same as cosine of the firing angle. So it indicates that if alpha is increased, if firing angle is increased from zero value, then the power factor of the converter deteriorates. So the reactive power requirement of converter increases as the firing angle increases.